This video is sponsored by PCBWay. In this video, we will make a powerful series elastic actuator that can be used in force control mode in your legged robots, humanoid robots, and exoskeleton projects. The actuator is based on a powerful brushless motor, a ball screw, a set of springs, a potentiometer, and a magnetic encoder. We will build this actuator step by step, and we will test it to show how strong it is and how you can control the forces it exerts. In series elastic actuators, a spring is placed between the gear train and driven load to reduce the stiffness of the actuator. A position sensor measures the deflection of the spring, and the force output is computed using Hooke law. A closed control loop is used to regulate the motor torque or the motor target position to produce the desired output force. The resulting actuator has inherent shock tolerance, high force fidelity, low impedance, and good force control bandwidth. These characteristics are desirable in many applications, including legged robots, humanoid robots, exoskeletons, robotic arms, and adaptive suspensions. In our actuator, the reduction element is a ball screw commonly used for 3D printers. Ball screws are cheap, light, robust, reversible, and can produce a large range of reduction ratios. Normally, 3D printed ball screws have an ending machine with this shape. However, there are a lot of manufacturers willing to deliver a custom ending. In our case, we have ordered a ball screw with a 90mm long and 10mm diameter ending. The screw part is 120 mm long. The other ending is standard and is designed to install an 8mm ball bearing. The screw has a diameter of 12 mm and the nut moves 4 mm per screw turn. We will start the work removing the ball nut. To do that, we use a plastic tube with a 10 mm external diameter and 8 mm internal diameter. The tube will hold the balls of the ball nut in place when we remove it, otherwise they will fall off. It is convenient to put a plastic tie to prevent the tube from coming out. We will install the ball screw on this powerful and massively produced brushless motor, which can deliver more than 3000 watts and 6 Nm. First, we will remove the circlip on the shaft. Holding the motor by the stator, we can hit the shaft to extract the rotor enough. Then we can pull until it comes out. The stator has three bearings, one on one side and two on the other side. The rotor holds the magnets and is linked to the shaft. Now we will extract the shaft from the rotor. The shaft is retained by two screws. However, it's very difficult to remove them. It was impossible for me. This kind of tools for removing broken screws did not work either. So I drilled the screws to remove them. However, there are manufacturers willing to provide the motors without screws. This would be much easier. Now, we will install the ball screw, replacing the original shaft. We have drilled the ball screw ending to fix it to the rotor. Before installing it, we will insert a separator and a gear for the encoder. We will explain this later. Then, we insert some more washers and an axial bearing that will take the axial load of the actuator. On the stator, we remove one of the two ball bearings and we insert the ball screw ending. Now, we replace the ball bearing with an axial ball bearing. Then, we can insert the rotor. And we can insert a headless screw to hold the rotor in place. The spur gear we installed in the shaft will be used to move another spur gear holding the magnet of the magnetic encoder. To hold everything in place, we 3D print this part. In this part, we put a screw and nuts as shaft for the second gear. In the second gear, we install a ball bearing and the magnet for the magnetic encoder. We will close the encoder assembly with a laser-cut aluminum part. For this video, I placed an order in PCBWay and in 10 days I received my laser cut parts. PCBWay is an online service for your machining needs, providing CNC machining, 3D printing, sheet metal fabrication, injection molding, laser cutting, and of course PCB making services. After uploading my files to the PCB website, I could choose the materials and I got a quote almost instantly. Head on over to PCBWay and take a look at their services to see what's best for your projects. You can check out PCBWay today by going to the link in my description. With this laser cut part, we can close the encoder assembly. We will use an MT6701 magnetic encoder. After soldering the wires, we fix it to the aluminum part. And we screw the whole assembly together using the threaded holes in the motor. Now we start with the spring assembly that is mounted on the ball bearing nut. We use another laser cut part to fix 6 4mm screws. In these screws, we insert the die springs, which are very strong for their size. Then we insert the ball bearing nut. And we install another set of 6 springs. Now we add some nuts, which can be used to preload the springs. We complete the spring assembly with this round flange part, commonly used in 3D printers. Note that the screws are not fixed to the ball bearing nut, and they can slide through it. Now we need to measure the spring compression. For that, we use a small potentiometer that we fix to one side of the assembly. To measure the distance to the nut, we add this 3D printed part. Now we can install the spring assembly in the ball screw. To finish this part, we add a ball bearing at the end of the ball screw. The output shaft is made out of a 25mm tube that slides through a linear ball bearing. The output rod is made of 2 ball joints, a screw, and an aluminum tube. This output rod will allow some linear misalignment of the load. The output rod is installed with the help of this 3D printed part. We install a headless screw in this hole to fix the rod. This point will slide along the linear bearing, which will take the radial loads. And finally, we install the output set. For the body of the actuator, we will use an aluminum tube, 200mm long and 50mm in diameter. We will cut one end of the tube to insert there the magnetic encoder assembly. The linear bearing is inserted in a 3D printed adapter and inserted in the body tube. Now we must prevent the rotation of the ball screw nut when the motor rotates. For that, we will take advantage of this threaded hole present in most ball screws. In this hole, we insert a screw with an adapter, and in the screw, we install a small ball bearing. The ball bearing will slide along the slot in this laser cut aluminum part, which is fixed to the inner part of the actuator body. And finally, we assemble the body to the motor set. To hold everything together, we use 3 T-shaped nuts inserted in the 3D printed part. We complete the output part with a 3D printed ending and a motorcycle fork cover that will protect the linear ball bearing. Now the actuator is complete. Turning the motor by hand, we can move the output rod in and out. The actuator weighs 1.8 kg. Oh, I forgot to add some wires to the potentiometer. For testing the actuator, we have connected it to an O-drive control board and a 6S lithium battery. The output rod is attached to a lever with a 1:10 ratio. The stroke of the actuator is 40 mm, and the maximum speed can reach 170 mm per second. Now, we add 8 kg to the lever, which corresponds to 800 newtons in the actuator. The actuator can lift the load without problem. In previous videos of this channel, we have seen that a similar actuator can exert more than 3000 newtons. Now the motor is holding its position, and we measure the resistance of the potentiometer, which is proportional to the force. We will use this measure to implement force control. Here, the actuator is using the force feedback to behave as a spring with medium stiffness. Here, the actuator is behaving as a spring with high stiffness. And here, as a spring with low stiffness. Finally, in this test, the actuator is exerting a constant force. If the weight is above its equilibrium point, it will go up. If it gets below the equilibrium point, it will go down. Thanks for watching!